How to look at progress in AI? Should you be happy or be concerned? Where is artificial intelligence headed? It has become a topic of intense debate. On one side of the spectrum, we have voices like Eric Schmidt, the former CEO of Google, who believes that AI is severely underhyped. He says that AI will be more transformative than the internet. Of course, Google is in the AI business. Somewhere in the middle, a recent article in New York Times pointed out that nations are scrambling but are also investing billions in AI to avoid being left behind, signaling both an opportunity and anxiety. On the other hand, practitioners soberly remind us that more than 80% of AI projects fail to deliver on their promises. With such a broad spectrum of opinions, it's natural to wonder where AI truly stands today. Should we be excited or concerned? AI is not a monolithic entity. It's an umbrella term that covers a range of technologies, each at a different stage of maturity. By breaking down AI into its subdisciplines, we can better understand where genuine progress has been made and where the hype might be overshadowing reality. Also, instead of accepting opinions, let's use an AI maturity spectrum to be more objective. So let's dive in. Let's start with the basics, decision trees. Though not technically AI, decision trees are foundational to many AI systems. These graphical structures allow us to make decisions based on predetermined criteria. For example, if you decide whether to approve a loan for a client, a decision tree could guide you through a series of yes or no and questions. Does the applicant have good credit score? Is their income sufficient? And so on. We understand decision trees well, and they work effectively when the data and conditions are well defined. However, they're limited to deterministic outcomes, and they cannot handle the complexity and uncertainty that AI aims to address. Here's where decision trees are on the maturity spectrum. They're pretty mature. Now let's move to machine learning, which has been the workhorse of AI and has made significant advancements. ML models use data to identify patterns and make decisions and predictions. The success of machine learning is underpinned by its strong foundation in statistics. Over the past 20 years, machine learning has transitioned from academic research to widespread industrial applications. For instance, machine learning powers the fraud detection systems that protect our credit card accounts. You might have had your credit card automatically blocked on a suspected transaction. Another everyday application of machine learning is the movie recommendation engines behind services like Netflix and Amazon. These systems analyze your past viewing and purchasing behavior to suggest what you might enjoy next. These recommendations are not just a novelty. They drive significant business value by keeping users engaged and boosting sales. The efficiency of these systems has been proven over years of deployment, making machine learning one of the most mature and reliable forms of AI. Here's where machine learning is on the maturity spectrum. Computer vision is another area where AI has made significant progress in the past few decades. Computer vision enables machines to interpret and understand visual data. It initially started out with some basic feature-based recognition, but has evolved into complex neural networks that are capable of highly accurate image analysis. This technology inspects products on assembly lines, monitors public spaces, and even recognizes faces. In manufacturing, computer vision systems inspect products for defects in real time, ensuring quality control and reducing waste. Here's where computer vision is on the maturity spectrum. The narrative becomes more nuanced when we move into the realm of large language models, like OpenAPI's GPT series. LLMs have made impressive strides in understanding and generating human language. These models can write essays, generate code, and even simulate conversations. However, they come with significant challenges like hallucinations and large resource hogs. Hallucinations happen when AI generates plausible but incorrect or nonsensical information. At this time, generative AI might be more suitable for internal-facing applications because employees tend to be more forgiving. It can help their jobs, but they are still in control. For instance, companies are exploring generative AI to create marketing content, design products, and even compose music. The speed at which it can generate content is impressive, but accuracy is often questionable. That makes it both a groundbreaking tool and a potential risk, depending on where it's used. Here's where Gen AI is on the maturity spectrum. Let's look even further ahead. Cognitive AI is a branch of AI that remains largely unexplored. Cognitive AI aims to replicate human-like thinking and problem-solving abilities. This could involve not just recognizing patterns or generating content, but understanding context, reasoning, and making complex decisions. While current AI technologies have some basic capabilities in this area, there's a long way to go, and research in this area is still ongoing. AI systems could generate entirely new ideas or concepts, pushing the boundaries of creativity and innovation. But that remains speculative and mainly in the realm of academic research. Here's where cognitive AI is on the maturity spectrum. Artificial general intelligence, or AGI, is something that possesses human-like intelligence across many domains. While many believe we are close to achieving this, it's most likely that we're still in the era of narrow AI, where systems excel at specific tasks but lack a generalized thinking abilities that humans have. For example, today, I cannot use a computer vision system that detects defects to also identify credit card fraud and generate a poem. These systems have differently been fine-tuned with different underlying technologies and are trained on different sets of data. They cannot cross-platform. Here's where AGI is on the maturity spectrum. Beyond AGI lies the theoretical concept of superintelligence, an AI that surpasses human intelligence by orders of magnitude. While intriguing, superintelligence remains purely hypothetical, with more questions than answers about its potential impact. It is generally believed that if machines achieve superintelligence, humans may become irrelevant. There's a lot behind that statement, so let's table that for another video. Here's where superintelligence might be on the maturity spectrum. Should we be happy or concerned about AI's progress? The answer is that it depends. The right end of the spectrum is deterministic problems, meaning the answer is always the same. To manage your money, you want the bank to know exactly how much money is in your account. The middle of the spectrum is probabilistic, meaning the answer has a little bit of probability associated with it. Today, the weather in your area is predicted with probability, so it is sometimes wrong. The left end of the spectrum is heuristic and artistic, capturing creativity and innovation that has to do with exploration. Math and language did not exist. They were created to represent concepts, to understand the world around us, and to communicate. Humans still excel at the left end of the spectrum. The brain is packed with a lot more functionality, consuming only 20 watts of power and keeping you alive and active. Compare this with ChatGPT, which has narrow functionality, requires upward of 1 megawatt of power, and is not truly creative, nor does it understand context fully. As you reflect on AI's progress, think about how these technologies can add value to your life and work today. But you have to stay informed and cautious about tomorrow's promises. My team and I now offer consulting and end-to-end implementation services. If you need our services, please reach out. If you enjoyed watching this video, please consider subscribing. For a one-page visual of this video, sign on to my mailing list. Thank you very much.